A Forsaken Garden by Algernon Charles Swinburne. Read by Nick Gisburn. In a coign of the cliff between lowland and highland, at the sea down's edge between windward and lee, walled round with rocks as an inland island, the ghost of a garden fronts the sea. A girdle of brushwood and thorn encloses the steep square slope of the blossomless bed, where the weeds that grew green from the graves of the roses now lie dead. The fields fall southward, abrupt and broken, to the low last edge of the long lone land. If a step should sound, or a word be spoken, would a ghost not rise at the strange guest's hand? So long have the grey bare walks lain guestless. Through branches and briars, if a man make way, he shall find no life but the sea winds, restless, night and day. The dense, hard passage is blind and stifled, that crawls by a track none turn to climb, to the straight waste place that the years have rifled of all but the thorns that are touched not of time. The thorns he spares when the rose is taken, the rocks are left when he wastes the plain. The wind that wanders, the weeds wind-shaken, these remain. Not a flower to be pressed of the foot that falls not. As the heart of a dead man, the seed plots are dry. From the thicket of thorns, whence the nightingale calls not, could she call, there were never a rose to reply. Over the meadows that blossom and wither, rings but the note of a sea-bird's song. Only the sun and the rain come hither, all year long. The sun burns sere, and the rain dishevels one gaunt bleak blossom of scentless breath. Only the wind here hovers and revels in a round where life seems as barren as death. Here there was laughter of old, there was weeping, haply of lovers none ever will know, whose eyes went seaward 100 sleeping years ago. Heart hand fast in heart as they stood, look thither, did he whisper, look forth from the flowers to the sea, for the foam flowers endure, while the rose blossoms wither, and men that love lightly may die, but we. And the same wind sang, and the same wave whitened, and forever the garden's last petals were shed, in the lips that had whispered, the eyes that had lightened, love was dead. Or they loved their life through, and then went whither, and were one to the end, but what end, who knows? Love as deep as the sea, as a rose must wither, as the rose-red seaweed mocks the rose. Shall the dead take thought for the dead to love them? What love was ever as deep as the grave? They are loveless now as the grass above them, or the wave. All are at one now, roses and lovers, not known of the cliffs, or the fields, or the sea. Not a breath of the time that has been hovers in the air now soft with a summer to be. Not a breath shall sweeten the seasons hereafter, of flowers or of lovers that laugh now or weep, when as they who are free now of weeping and laughter, we shall sleep. Here death may deal not again for ever, here change may come, not till all change end. From the graves they have made, they shall rise up, never, who have left naught living, to ravage and rend. Earth, stones and thorns of the wild ground growing, while the sun and the rain live, these shall be, till a last wind's breath, upon all these blowing, roll the sea. Till the slow sea rise and the sheer cliff crumble, till terrace and meadow the deep gulfs drink, till the strength of the waves of the high tides humble the fields that lessen, the rocks that shrink. Here now, in his triumph, where all things falter, stretched out on the spoils that his own hands spread, like a god self-slain on his own strange altar, death lies dead.